We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
Hello friends, today we are learning about finite element analysis examples. So today we have to learn the basic example of static structure analysis. This static structure analysis, as per our previous theory of the FEA, steps of FEA, types of element of FEA, how we can use the element stiffness and all these things. So let's start. But before starting, first we have to require some important things: pen, notebooks, as well as your calculator. It is a mandatory for all students. Let's start. So important terms for the example, all students must have to write down in one page. This is the most important formula for the example purpose. Let's start. First, we are starting with the relation between the displacement, strain and stress. So as we know that this is the best particularly relation between all these three terms. Displacement we can consider as a U. It will be at particularly any node of the element. Strain is equal to B into Q. Stress is equal to E into B into Q. Here we are considering E is the element modulus of elasticity of the material. So when we are taking a stepped bar, hope it will be a different material after the one step. But sometime we are taking only one single material, considered as a single material, like plastic, or we can say stainless steel, MS, or any other. And B is equal to one constant is there. It is depend on the length of the particularly elements and one matrix formulation, 1 by L E minus 1, 1. And Q is the displacement at particularly node. So if we are taking a one element, then particularly node have the particularly two displacement, Q1 and Q2. So we can find out displacement at each and every node, but strain is depend on the particularly element. Okay, let's start another things. So important terms for the example. So element stiffness matrix have the particularly two types of method. First one is the potential energy approach and second one is the Gillikin approach. So both approach conclude that KQ is equal to F. So here if we are presenting KQ is equal to F, means K is equal to the particularly element global stiffness matrix, Q is equal to displacement at each and every node, and F is equal to force is occur at particularly node. So if we are concluding in the form of the element purpose, so matrix is we can present like the K11, K12, K21, K22, and particularly Q is already we shown in the previous slide, Q1, Q2 as well as F1, F2. So if we have the cantilever beam like this, if I have one cantilever beam is there, okay, so here first side is the fixed side, so I can consider F is equal to 0. So this is the most important term we will shown in the particularly exam point of view on example time. So let's go ahead. Now the important another terms is the particularly the element stiffness matrix for each element would be the we can present like this. So if we want to find out element, we know that the third step of the particularly FEA is the element stiffness matrix for particularly element. So for that purpose, we are find out K1, K2, K3, or we can say consider KE is equal to AE open L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Here you can show the one upper side and outer side one global degree of freedom is there. ijk we can consider is node number, starting node, and j is the ending node. I is the starting node and j is the ending node. So this node is the very important during the example time, because if we have three element and if we are starting for the second, starting from the second element, then instead of ijk we can write down node number 2, 2, 3. So we will observe such thing in the example. So another is the elementary approach. It is a one mathematical form, we know that very well. So is as previous we discussed that if I am taking any cantilever beam and this my fixing is there, this one side is fixed is there, then I can consider at that place force and displacement both are the zero. So if I am considering this zero, then if any also K12 and K13 if it is a zero, then in particularly one line if it is a 2 0, then it is a one particularly elementary approach. And in the we can show such kind of elementary approach in the trust analysis also. So this is the basic things that we have to know properly. So now another thing is the reaction force can be found by using a react. This is the reaction force. So previously we learned that KQ is equal to F, but for reaction force R is equal to KQ minus F. So we know that such terms are there. Stress, we already know stress is equal to E into B Q and Q2. So in previous form stress is equal to, we can write down E, and if I am putting the value of B, then the formula is different. It is a 1 upon LE Q1 Q2, that we have to know. Now this is the complete the important terms. Let's start with the one beautiful our book example. This example will be asked in GTU also so many times. So first, as we know that our class practice, we first have to read data for two times. First we have to identify the values, and second time what they want to describe or what they want to determine. Let's start. An axial stepped bar is shown in the figure. It is subjected to an axial pull of 50 kN. If the material of the bar is uniform, so here material of bar is totally uniform, so there is a no variation in the material. So as per that I can say that the modulus of elasticity is same at whole beam. So modulus of elasticity as a 200 gigapascal, determine the displacements and stress of each of the section using 1ds per element. So here they clearly mentioned that we have to utilize 1ds per element. In previous lecture we learned that 1d, 2d and the 3d, three elements types are there. Instead of that we have to select 1ds per element. Also confirm the result using a conventional principle. So here first we have to start with the conventional principle method. So let's start with the conventional principle method. So again, this is the first time of the reading. Now in second time of reading we have to identify each and every component. An axial stepped bar is shown in the figure. It is subject to an axial pull. We know that the axial pull is, you can observe here, one axial pull F is equal to 50 kN is already at the particularly center. This one, okay. So if material of the bar is uniform, the material is uniform 200 gigapascal, so we have to, this is the important line, determine the displacement and the stress of the each element. So for we have to particularly identify the stress of the each and every element. Let's start. So as per that we know the steps of the FEM. Our first step is the discretization. So here you can observe that in the downward side figure we are discretize it in the 1ds per element, as we learned here previously. So one side is the fix, then we are putting the element number in round 1, 2 and 3, as well as the element at particularly each and every node is 1, 2, 3, 4 and up to an F. So each and every node have the degree of freedom in the form of the Q1 F1 Q2 F2 Q3 F3 and Q4 F4. So here particularly we have the 4 node and we have to work for the 4 node. So as per data we can say that, you can observe in the upper side diagram The length is given to for first element 200, second element 400, third element 300. As well as they are giving the cross section area A 300 mm², 200 mm² and 19 mm². So we can write down it like this. So this is the given value. When we start the example, first we have to indicate the given value. A1 is equal to 300 mm, to A2 is equal to 200 mm, A3 is equal to 1900. Here we can consider E1, E2, E3 is equal, and we can write down 200 gigapascal. L1 is equal to 200 mm, L2 is equal to 400 mm, and L3 is equal to 300 mm. So here 200 gigapascal is there. If we convert into the pascal, then we can say that E1, E2, E3 is equal to 200 into 10 raised to 3. So this unit conversion is very important during the example time. So let's start. So for first element purpose, we have to find out K1. For that purpose, first I have to, we know that the K is equal to A1 E1 open L1, in bracket particularly we can say 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So first we have to find out first element purpose. So everyone ready for it? Okay, so write down this formula in your notebook and put the value of A1, E1 and L1. So we can consider 300 into 200 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 200. First length is a 200. So 200, 200 cancel. We can say that 3 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm. So this is the first value we can put into the K1. So we know that this value, we are inserting the 3 inside the bracket, or we can say in the matrix. And you can observe here the global degree of freedom. First element start with the two nodes, node number 1 to 2. So here we are considering 1 to 2, 1 to 2. So here, this is important during the global stiffness matrix. So similarly, we have to find out K2 and K3. So let's see. So we can putting the value of the A2, E2 by L2. And here we got the answer is 1 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm. We are inserting same. So we can find out global stiffness matrix. Have you observed here? The element is written in the another form. It is a 1, 2, 2, 2. Okay. So this is the important terms, as well as similarly we have to find out K3. Now this is the particularly element wise step number 3, and it is nothing but element stiffness matrix. So here K1, K2 and K3, all three are considering as a element stiffness matrix. So what is the fourth step? We already know that the fourth step is the global stiffness matrix. For global stiffness matrix, let's start. So here, have you observed that already in the global stiffness matrix we are indicating 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. Now how we can putting the value of the 1 2 3 4? So it is the important, another important things are there, because we are comparing the global stiffness matrix with element stiffness matrix. So in the previous slide if we are write down 1 1 any other place is 1 1 is there? No. So here 1 1 is the 3. So in the second slide, first component here I can write down, first component is the 3. Okay, so let's see the whatever the answer is there. Okay, so this is the particularly answer, 3 minus 3. So when the 2 2 is there, so we are addition 3 plus 1 1 into 0.6. so this is the combination of the 2 2 and combination of 3 3. So other components are the 0 0 0, and as you observe here, so if I am identified in proper manner, then my conclusion is 3 minus 3 0 0 minus 3 4 minus 1 0 0 minus 1 1.6 0 minus 0.6 0 0 minus 0.6 0.6. So now this is the, here we are finally conclude the global stiffness matrix K. Now if we find out KQ is equal to F, then we are putting the all three values as per the this diagram. So 10 raised to 5 is different, K putting the value of A, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and F1, F2, F3, F4. Now as per the diagram, we know that the it is a cantilever beam. So Q1 is equal to 0. So here downside we are clearly mentioned that Q1 is the 0, and as well as F1, F2, F3 is equal to 0. Why it is F1, F2, F3 is equal to? It is already given in the diagram. On the node number 4, only force F4 is equal to 50 kN. That's why we are considering F1, F2, F3 is equal to 0 and F4 is equal to 50 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. We are putting this value in our particularly formula. So let's see, when we are putting this formula, you can observe the highlighted yellow part is there. This highlighted yellow part is indicate that this is the common cancellation, particularly of cancellation, or we can say elementary approach we are utilizing. So due to that, we can reduce the matrix size. Now it is a 3 by 3 matrix. We are comparing it. We are putting the value of Q2, Q3 and Q4. It is an unknown. We know that in this step 5, we have to find the unknown. So these are the unknowns to displacement. Because we are doing the static structure analysis, we are applying the force, and in the first slide we can observe that the degree of freedom is the displacement. So now we have to find out the value of Q2, Q3 and Q4. By mathematical solution we can observe that 10 raised to 5 into 4 into 10 as per the first one. So first component considering with the first column of the Q, so 4 into Q2 minus Q3. Why we are not write down Q4? Because the last value of this component, it will be a 0. That's why we cannot write down the Q4. So after that, we can conclude the first formula. Q3 is equal to 4 Q2. Let's see. Another, we have to find out the second formula. And when we are combining formula A, B and C, we can find out the value of something. Q4 is equal to 1.5 m. as per that we can find out the reaction also. So here the reaction is, sorry, one thing is missing. So here on the downside we can find out the value of all these three, Q2, Q3, Q4. Okay, so this is the important things. So this is the displacement value, or we can say unknown as per the step number 5. Now step number 6 is depend on the reaction and the stress. So we already know that the R is equal to KQ minus F. We are putting the value of R is equal to KQ minus F. We are taking only cancellation rho. Why I am taking a cancellation rho? I am taking a cancellation rho because the when we cantilever beam is there. So on first element there is a fixed support is there. So obviously reaction will be at the fixed support. So we have to find out on the first call, first row and the column of the Q1, Q2, Q3. We know that Q1 is the 0 because the one side is a fixed is there. So now we have to find out R is equal to minus 15 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. So have you observed that this answer, this is the very important things are there. When we are taking a such kind of information, so here the minus 15 into 10 raised to 3 Newton, it is considering as a is equal to R1 is equal to the F4. So this is the important things, terms are there. So now we have to find out stress is equal to E into BQ. We are putting the value of B, we are putting the value of particularly Q. So now we have to find out stress in the particularly element number 1 is equal to 167 Newton per mm square. Similarly, we have to find out for element number 2 and element number 3. Okay, so this is the particularly full example of the static structure analysis in particularly conventional manner. In similarly, next lecture we have to observe potential energy principle, or we can say potential energy approach, with the same example. So best of luck everyone.